they will begin to what? Have their own faith, and they will begin to what? Believe God for their own need. So giving into the kingdom of God is the best way to help the poor. Y'all believe that? I'm going to say, give a man a fish. How does that go?
Teach him how to fish.
You give him a fish, you're going to have to give him one what? Every day, right? But if you teach him how to fish, then what? You've solved your problem. He can go and catch his own fish. That's the same principle. Okay, now, the Lord will preserve him and keep him alive. See, this is a direct promise when you have been faithful in your tithing and giving. You can always call God to remembrance by this scripture. God said he will preserve him. Look at there. I don't care how sick, I don't care what the prognosis might be. The Lord will what? Preserve him and what? Keep him alive. And he shall be what? Blessed upon the earth. And thou wilt not deliver him until the will of his what? Enemies. The Lord will what? Strengthen him upon the what? Bed of what? Languishing. Thou wilt make all his bed in his sickness. Now when I read this to the average believer, they have never heard this before. And if they've never heard it before, then they can't stand on it. They can't use that. But once they understand that if they have been faithful givers and supporters of the kingdom of God for years, you can call God's remembrance to his promise with this particular scripture. Now, I've never seen it fail in the cases in which people have actually been consistent givers. I've never seen it fail. Although the prognosis in several instances look very dismal. All right, how many still with me? How many still with me? So God creates the fruit of our lips. What does that mean? It means that whatever your environment, whatever you experience, whatever your world that seemingly is evolving is going to be the product of what you are what? Speaking. God is going to what? Create the things that you are what? Speaking. You say over and over. It's a consistent pattern of speaking and being in harmony with God's word. That's going to really bless you. Amen. So I'm trying to, now Proverbs 18, that's a scripture, that a man's belly shall be satisfied with the fruit of his mouth, and with the increase of his lips shall he be filled. Death and life is in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall what? Eat the fruit thereof. Let's be familiar with that scripture. All right, we've gone over this before. Proverbs 22:28. I really use that a lot in my prayer. Lord, you said I can decree a thing, and whatever I decree, it shall be what? Established. And the light shall what? Shine. All right, Proverbs 12:25. It says what? Everybody together. All right, who wants to talk about that just for a moment? Heaviness in the heart makes for what? Maketh it stoop. But a good word maketh it glad. All right, where's the good word going to come from? All right. From your mouth. All right, from somebody else's mouth. Sometimes, but until you what? You receive and you say what somebody else is saying, if they're saying it, then you gotta what? You gotta agree with what? What the word say. Amen. Sister Marianne, can you conceive of how you can be so burdened down, so discouraged, so frustrated? I mean, most people get like that. Do they focus on speaking the word, or do they want to wallow in their situation? They don't want nothing about but giving themselves up, but they want pity, they want to feel sorry for themselves, right? So most people do not turn to the word when they get what? Really depressed. A lot of people don't. Until later on, they say, oh, they put two or three days later, they think, oh, yeah, I should have. They would have had that pity party for a while, right? And after, when I tried everything, when you try everything, and everything is failed, try Jesus. That's the way we do.
A little late.
All right. That's not the way we should do that. Because if you want your heart to what? Perk up. If you want to what? Turn it around. Then you got to what? Amen. A good word. Somebody say a good word.
A good word.
So the least word is a good word. Good word. All right, brother, what's a good word? All right, word of God. Now, the word of God that pertains to what? Whatever need, a problem, a situation, or whatever you're going through. You just don't turn to any word, right? You have to turn to the word that pertains to your what? Deliverance. Because the mouth of the just shall what? Deliver. Amen. I want you to say that. I've never heard nobody say that. As long as we've been going, I have never heard nobody in here say that.
Wow.
This will be the last time until I call your attention to it again. Now, years ago, some of y'all were here, years ago, during prayer time, Sister Denise, you remember that we just walked around the mouth of the righteous. Y'all remember when you should just walk around on the floor? Sometimes kneeling. That's all we would do for an hour. We would just what? That's all we did. Amen. But now we wait for Brother Travis. Brother Travis don't read it, just don't get ready. Brother Travis don't say it. Not for everybody, but I'm just calling your attention that we really need to what? Pay what pastor passes out some attention. And I don't know what those meditation books are. Maybe I better make an appointment. I should be mad. I don't know what they, I still use it, those things. I pull them out. Great. When I get tired of this, move to this. I get tired of that, move it. Tired of that? These are different meditations. You understand what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Tired of that? Over here. Then after about 2 or 3 or 4 weeks, some hit me and said, I need to go back over here. And I go right back over there. Then I said, I need to go over here again. But you don't just pack it down, y'all. And don't.